As Canada adjusts to life in lockdown, many are turning to cloth masks when disposable masks like these aren't available. But one epidemiologist says if you're not cleaning yours properly, you could be putting yourself in harm's way.
It's something that will very happily collect bacteria, both bacteria that you breathe out and that you suck in from the air around you. Bacteria can then grow, reproduce, being nurtured by your moist breath, and can reproduce to very large quantities. Bacteria will double every 20 minutes, so in a few hours you can get quite a colony going.
Masks have been in short supply since the start of the pandemic. Hospitals have struggled to get stock of the N95 respirator, the gold standard in medical-grade PPE. For people not on the front lines, cloth masks have emerged as an alternative. But there's only one study on cloth masks from the United Kingdom, and the results were not promising.
It found, well, infection rates were a lot higher among people who wore cloth masks. It also found that that the cloth masks let through about 97% of particles. So it only really stopped about 3% of particles. And that is a two-layer cotton mask that was actually designed for hospital use. So much better, say, than your average torn-up T-shirt, for example.
Officials in cities like Calgary and Montreal are urging people to wear masks as another layer of protection. Public Health Canada hasn't said the same, but says masks can be an additional measure to protect those around you. It even has a page advising how to make cloth face masks yourself, but details on how to clean them are relegated to a different page. Professor Furness says he's not advising against wearing cloth masks. He wears one himself, but he says people need to know they're still at risk.
I think it's negligent to tell people that they should use them, to tell people how to make them, and to not provide the safety information around keeping the mask clean and understanding that our bodies are not designed to have a fabric or a membrane like that outside our mouths.
Now, Furness says he's not advising people not wear cloth masks. He's just asking people to be aware of the risks associated with them and take care of them properly. Furness himself says he never wears one for longer than 2 hours, and when he gets home, he doesn't just wash them, he boils them. As he says, while soap can destroy viruses, heat is the best way to destroy bacteria, which can cause other infections. In Ottawa, Shao Li Li, City News.